A splendiferous morning to each one present. William Shakespeare is universally regarded as the greatest dramatist and the finest poet of the English language. He lived in England during the era of Queen Elizabeth I, of which historians consider the Elizabethan age as the peak of English culture. The exact birth date of William Shakespeare is unknown. However, based on the records of the parish register, he was baptized on April 26, 1564 in the Holy Trinity Church in Stratford-upon-Avon and buried there on April 25, 1616. According to the customs at that time, infants were usually baptized 3 days after their birth, and Shakespeare's birthday is usually celebrated on April 23rd, also the date of his death. He died at
reinvented and defined the English language to such a degree that his works are required study all over the world. As an actor, Shakespeare was present during the production of his plays and therefore wrote them with a very little stage direction. Shakespeare produced most of his known work between 1589 and 1613. His early plays were primarily comedies and histories, and these are regarded as some of the best work ever produced in these genres. To name a few of his works are comedies, All's Well That Ends Well, As You Like It, The Comedy of Errors, Love's Labour's Lost, The Merchant of Venice, A Midsummer Night's Dream.
Tragedies, Romeo and Juliet, Hamlet, Othello, King Lear, Macbeth, Antony and Cleopatra, The Tempest.
History, King John, Edward III, Henry IV, Part 1 and 2.
2016 commemorates Shakespeare's 400th anniversary year of Somewhere in the World is Reading Shakespeare. And even though he died 400 years ago, someone else is writing about him or acting in one of his plays.
So now we present to you one of his powerful characters, Marcus Antony. Mark Antony was one of the leaders who ruled Rome following Caesar's assassination. He was famous in the play Julius Caesar for his speech which turned and swayed the Romans against Brutus, following his group assassination of Caesar. Mark Antony speaks to Roman crowd after Brutus tried to justify the killing of Julius Caesar. So here we present to you the funeral speech of Mark Antony, famous for the immortal lines, "Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears." Act 3, Scene 2, Line 79, from Julius Caesar, authored by the great dramatist of the century, William Shakespeare.
"Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is often turned with their bones. So let it be with Caesar. The noble Brutus hath told you, Caesar was ambitious.
If it was so, it was previously had Caesar answered it. Here, under leave of Brutus and the rest, for Brutus is an honorable man. So are they all. All honorable men.
He was my friend, faithful and just to me. But Brutus said he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. He had brought many captives home to Rome, whose ransoms did the general coffers fill. Did this as Caesar seem ambitious?
When that ambition should be made of sterner step. Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see that. Brutus is an honorable man. You all did see that on the new buckle I thrice presented him. The kingly crown, which he did thrice refuse. Was this ambition? Yet Brutus says he was ambitious, and sure, he is an honorable man.
Not to disapprove what Brutus spoke,
But here I am to speak what I do know. You all did love him once, not without cause. What cause withholds you then to mourn for him? Oh, judgment, thou art fled to brutish beasts, and men have lost their reason. Bear with me. My heart is in the coffin, there with Caesar, and I must pause till it come back to me.
Caesar might have stood against the world. Now lies he there, and none so poor to do him reverence? Oh, masters, if I were disposed to stir your hearts and minds to mutiny and rage, I should do Brutus wrong and Cassius wrong, who, you all know, are honorable men. I will not do them wrong. I rather choose to wrong the dead, to wrong myself and you, than I will wrong such honorable men.
But here I found it in his closet. Says will, let but the commons hear this testament, which, pardon me, I do not mean to read, and they would go and kiss dead Caesar's wounds.
I dip the beggar head of him for memory, and, dying, mention it within your wills, bequeathing it as a rich legacy, and to their shoes. Thank you.
The actor speaks to himself or herself, relating thoughts and feelings, thereby also sharing them with the audience, giving off the illusion of being a series of unspoken reflections. If other characters are present, they keep silent or disregarded by the speaker.
Now we have Lucavia with a soliloquy from the play Hamlet, delivered by the character Hamlet. This soliloquy was delivered when Hamlet gets to know that the priest he had called for his brother's death investigation, he himself was a murderer. Over to Lucavia.
Breaks my pen across, plucks of my beard and blows it in my face. Tweaks me by the nose, gives me the lie I the throat as deep as lungs. Who does me this? Huh? Swoons, I should take it, for it cannot be but I am. Pigeon liver and lag gall. To make oppressions bitter, or I this? I should have fettered all the region kites with the shraves offal. Bloody body willing. Remorseless, treacherous, witcherous, kindness villain. Oh, waitens, why, what an ass am I? But this is most brave, that I, son of a dear father, murdered, prompted to my revenge by heaven and hell, just like a whore, unpacked my heart with words, just like a very tramp. Oh, scullion, thank you.
All the world is a stage, and all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and their entrances, and one man in his sight plays many parts. Seven ages as you like it.
If to do were as easy as to know what were good to do, chapels had been churches, and poor men's cottage, princes' palaces, the merchant of Venice.
There is nothing either good or bad, but thinking makes it do. Hamlet by William Shakespeare.
Some are born great, some achieve greatness, some have greatness thrust upon them. The Twelfth Night by William Shakespeare.
If music be the food of love, then play on. The Twelfth Night by William Shakespeare. To be
or not to be, that is a question. Hamlet by William Shakespeare.
Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. Julius Caesar by William Shakespeare.
Now is the winter of our discontent. Richard III by William Shakespeare. Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant never taste of death but once. Julius Caesar by William Shakespeare.
How sharper than a serpent's tooth it is to have a tankless shine. King Lear by William Shakespeare.
If you prick us, do we not bleed? If you tickle us, do we not laugh? If you poison us, do we not die? And if you wrong us, shall we not revenge? The Merchant of Venice by William Shakespeare.
Ah, that glisters is not gold. The Merchant of Venice by William Shakespeare.